Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. This video is going to be about introducing you to the tools of a cutting room. First, here we have some safety wear. You've got your goggles to stop bits getting in your eyes, and you have your apron to protect your uniform and to keep your tie or anything that might flap around loose from getting tangled up in your machinery. You also have dust masks if you're working with very, very dusty wood, such as MDF. You don't want to be breathing in those particles. So that's a must for when you're doing a practical lesson. But back to what we're focusing on today, and we have the tools in this cupboard. So starting from the top, we have our tenon saw, a nice substantial blade. It's great for doing straight cuts. Quite big teeth, which are the jaggedy triangles on the very edge of the blade. These are called the teeth, and they are the things that cut through your material. This is for wood. You also have a coping saw, like so. And as you notice, much, much smaller blade and much finer teeth. Now, this is for wood as well, but it's also for plastics and other various easier to cut material. Now, the reason why it's got a small blade is this allows you to turn and be very agile with your cut, so you can get real good curves. And this blade would, see that blade wouldn't allow you to create curves. So that's the main difference between these two, your detailed work. Moving down a bit further, we have various files. So once you've cut your shape, you can smooth off your cut line. So the files come in various shapes. You've got curved and flat. You've got needle files to get in those hard to reach places. And these can work on metals as well, and plastics, and wood. Very useful. And if you're building up, so you first cut line, you can get your files to smooth that off. After your files, you can get to sandpaper to really get a finer finish on that edge. And your sandpaper is at the bottom of the cupboard, and the numbers indicate the grit. Now, grit is as if, how can I put this? The higher number, say 150, the higher the grit, the finer it is. The lesser the grit, 120, the more rougher it is. The grit is almost like the particles which are attached to the paper. So the higher number, the smoother it is. And you start rough and work your way to smooth. Eventually, in certain situations, you can use this, which is, but you wet this slightly as well, and so for plastics, you get a really, really smooth finish. This is very, very super fine. Got your sandpapers. Back up here again. To the left of the files, we have our rasp plane or the surform. This is like your cheese grater for wood. It removes a lot of your waste at a quicker rate, but it's a much, much rougher finish. So you start with this, transfer to your file to refine it, and again to sandpaper for the final meeting. We then have a wood plane. This shaves off fine layers of your wood. You can adjust the amount it cuts off or shaves off by adjusting the blade. The blade is a tiny, pokes through a bit there on the bottom, which is similar to a pencil sharpener but a lot more hardcore. Then have your tri-square. This is awesome for getting a straight line off of an edge that you know to be straight. Gives you a good right angle. Brilliant, very useful for when you're making things like boxes. Now before we move on to the hammers, another saw we have, but not in the cupboard, just in the storeroom, is a hacksaw. This is good for metal. Similar ability as a coping saw. Gives you maneuverability to the fine blade and the tiny, tiny teeth. We then go back down to the hammers. And in this cupboard, we have two types. We have the ball pane, which is P-E-I-N, and the cross pane. I think that's how I pronounce it. These are good for metalwork, shaping your material, such as shaping aluminium sheets to a certain curvature or however, or putting nails in. We have got in the storeroom, we've got a bigger hammer for your heavy duty hammering, more weight behind it, and this has got a claw end, so it's a claw hammer. This is good for removing nails from your product or wood. Now next, we also have, before we move on, we have a rubber mallet in the storeroom, and this is great for the more gentle work, but it's mainly used for chisels. And chisels is also we have in the storeroom. And similar to the plane, the wood plane, hand plane earlier, it shaves off wood or removes chunks. You sort of layer it into the, place it onto the old material, and you finally tap away at it. You can remove chunks or strips or however much you require. So these are your chisels. And they come in various sizes for what you need. Then at the very bottom, next to the sandpaper, you have your bench hook. And this goes in the vise. The vise grips there on the bench vise. And then this ledge allows you to place your material up against it. You can trap it there with your hand, which then allows you to cut into your material. And there we go. That's your introduction to the cupboard. It's useful to remember these names because you will need to use them as you write your report on your products, and as you develop your making diaries, you can refer to these names and the equipment you've used in your make journey. I hope it's been useful. Thank you for listening.